Hi. With a great say by Albert Einstein, wisdom is not a product of schooling, but of the lifelong attempt to acquire it. With this, we'll solve one of the problem in spur gear. The statement of this problem is as follows. Two spur gears are to be used for a rock crusher drive and are to be used for minimum size. The gears are to be designed for the following requirements. Power to be transmitted is 20 kilowatt. Speed of the pinion is 1200 rpm. Velocity ratio is 3.5:1. Tooth profile 20 degree stub involute. Determine module and face width for strength requirements only. Now we'll list out the given data from the given problem. Two spur gears. So here problem that belongs to spur gears are to be used for a rock crusher drive and are to be of minimum size. Minimum size in the sense here we supposed to go with the least number of teeth. The gears are to be designed for the following requirements. Power to be transmitted is 20 kilowatt, means power to be transmitted P is equal to 20 kilowatt or 20 into 10 to the 3 watts. Speed of the pinion is 1200 rpm. So here element has given pinion. So pinion, that is the first element. So here we are using for the first element suffix as 1. So N1, that is nothing but speed of pinion, that is equal to 1200 rpm. Velocity ratio is 3.5:1. Velocity ratio or transmission ratio or speed ratio I is equal to 3.5:1. Tooth profile 20 degree stub. Tooth profile, so pressure angle alpha will be 20 degree, stub involute profile. Determine module and face width. Here we supposed to find out the module M as well as face width B for strength requirements only. This is about the given data. Soon after listing the data, now we'll go to the solution, formula and solution. Here we need to go with the method like step-by-step procedure such as number of teeth on pinion and gear, checking for strength, evaluation of the module, and selecting the standard module, and then quoting the face width as well as exact module. So in that, the first unknown is number of teeth on pinion and gear, means we need to find the value of z1 and z2 first. So now by using the equation velocity ratio, I is equal to n1 by n2, that is equal to d2 by d1, that is equal to z2 by z1, by considering the last term in the equation, that is I is equal to Z2 by Z1. So I is equal to 3.5, that is equal to Z2 divided by Z1, or Z2 is equal to 3.5 into Z1. So here we have one equation with the two unknowns, means we need minimum two equations to solve or to find two unknowns. So we'll use one more relation, that is number of teeth relation, equation number 12.3b, page number 203. And the equation is Z1 square plus 2 into Z1 Z2, that is equal to 4 into K1 into Z2 plus K1 divided by sine square alpha. So now by replacing the term Z2 by Z1, we will get the relation as Z1 square plus 2 into Z1 into 3.5 into Z1, that is equal to 4 into 0.8 into 3.5 into Z1 plus 0.8 divided by sine square 20. Here 20 is nothing but the pressure angle, that is alpha. So by simplifying that, we are getting 8 Z1 square into 0.1169, that is equal to 11.2 Z1 plus 2.56. By bringing all terms to LHS and forming a standard equation, we used to get a quadratic equation with a form 935.2 into 10 raised to minus 3 Z1 square minus 11.2 Z1 minus 2.56, that is equal to 0. By simplifying this, we are getting, by solving this quadratic equation, we are getting number of teeth on pinion Z1, that is equal to 12.20, or that is approximately equal to 13. So now we have got the value Z1 is equal to 13 teeth, but it is not final because we supposed to refer a table with the standard set of number of teeth, that is least number of teeth what we supposed to consider either for pinion or gear, that is table number 12.4, page number 230. By referring this here, it will give guide to select gear tooth system. So here 14.5 degree full depth involute system he has given, 20 degree full depth involute system, and 20 degree stub tooth involute system he has given. In the problem, he mentioned that is 20 degree stub tooth profile teeth. So we supposed to go with the least number of teeth as 14. In our earlier calculation, we got 13. So that cannot be recommended. So we supposed to go with the value Z1 that is equal to 14. And assuming least number of teeth, just increasing plus 1 teeth. So Z1 is equal to 15 teeth. Next, we supposed to find number of teeth on the gate. That is by using the relation I is equal to Z2 divided by Z1, or Z2 is equal to 3.5 into Z1. So now we got the value Z1, that is number of teeth on pinion. By substituting that, we are getting number of teeth on gear, Z2 is equal to 52, or approximately equal to 53 teeth. Now we got the values of number of teeth on pinion as well as gear as 15 and 53. Now we'll go to evaluate the strength calculation, that is checking for the strength. Means here which member is weaker, either pinion is weaker or gear is weaker, because that conclusion is required. Because which member is weaker, we supposed to consider and we supposed to give the priority to that particular element. Later we supposed to do the design based on that particular. So now by using the equation, that is Lewis form factor, equation number 12.5, page number 12.5e, page number 204. Here form factor y, that is required to get the strength, that is a product sigma d into y. For pinion it is sigma d1 y1, and that of gear sigma d2 y2. Those two will evaluate later. Initially we must find out the value of Lewis form factor y. So now from this equation number 12.5e, page number 204, Lewis form factor y is equal to 0.175 minus 0.95 divided by z. Now we'll replace the notation y as y1 and z as z1, and by substituting the value of z1 and z2 correspondingly in the equation, we are getting y1 is equal to 0.1116, and y2, that is a Lewis form factor for the gear, that is equal to 0.1570. These two are the values of y1 and y2. Now here, since in the problem he has not given the material either for gear or pinion, so now by assuming material for pinion and gear as a 0.2% heat treated, in the design data handbook of 4th edition, Balvir Reddy and Mahadevan, in that by referring page number 234, table 12.7, allowable static stress for the material 0.2% heat treated will be 193.2 Newton per mm square. But here we assume both pinion as well as gear is made up of same material. So sigma D1, that is equal to sigma D2, that is allowable static stress for pinion as well as gear, that is equal to 193.2 Newton per mm square. Now based on this particular itself, we can go to the conclusion, that is when both pinion as well as gear is made up of same material, always pinion is a weaker member. We can do the design based on pinion, but still here we'll work out what is the other fundamental method we have. Suppose he has given two different materials, then what we have to do, that procedure I will explain. Now for the corresponding material from the same table, it is possible to get the value BHN in the last column. BHN1, that is Brinell hardness number of pinion as well as gear, both are equal, that is equal to 250. So after assuming the value sigma d as well as evaluating the Lewis form factor y1 y2, now we must get the product, that is sigma d1 y1 and sigma d2 y2. Either we can go with the final conclusion as both gear and pinion is made up of same material, pinion is weaker and design is based on pinion, or alternatively we can go with this method, that is sigma d1 y1. Sigma d1 is 0.2% carbon heat treated, that particular material with the allowable static stress is 193.2 into value of y1, Lewis form factor. So that value is 0.1116. By simplifying that, we are getting sigma d1 y1, that is equal to 21.5611 Newton per mm square. Similarly, sigma d2 y2, that is equal to 193.2 into 0.1570. So we are getting the product sigma d2 y2, that is equal to 30.3324 Newton per mm square. Now, by comparing these two products, that is 21.5611 and 30.3324, in that 30.3324 is the higher value. So, sigma D1 Y1 is less than sigma D2 Y2. So, obviously, pinion is weaker and design is based on pinion. After deciding a member which is weaker, that is a pinion is weaker, then we must take the, or we must give the importance to that particular weaker member only for the design, for safer design. Now, the next heading is module. Now, by using Lewis equation for beam strength of tooth from equation number 12.5b, page number 204, module M is equal to two of the equations we have, either in terms of tangential tooth load or in terms of tangential torque, that is M is equal to square root of Ft divided by sigma d into Cv into Ky, that is equal to 2 times the M suffix t divided by sigma d Cv Kyz whole raised to 1 by 3. So, in this it is possible to get the value Mt. So, we must go with the third term of the equation, that is M, that is equal to 2 Mt divided by sigma d into Cv into Kyz whole raised to 1 by 3. By simplifying that, we are getting M cube, that is equal to 2Mt divided by sigma d Cv Kyz. And here we know the weaker member is pinion, so we will use the suffix as 1. So we are getting M cube is equal to 2Mt suffix 1 divided by sigma d suffix 1 Cv K into Y1 Z1. We'll call this as equation number 1. Now, we'll evaluate the individual unknowns. Tangential torque, M suffix T1. By using a tangential force, F suffix T is equal to 2Mt divided by D. That is equation number 12.8a, page number 206. And here the weaker member is pinion. So, Ft1, that is equal to 2Mt suffix 1 divided by D1. We'll call that as equation number 2. Next will be power transmitting capacity P of spur gears by referring equation 12.4a, page number 204. By assuming service factor CS is equal to 1, we can go with this particular equation. If you are preferring that service factor of the gears, then we must refer one more equation. That will work out in next problem. Now, in this particular problem, since service factor of the member he has not mentioned, he has not given the importance, so we'll use the equation P, power P is equal to F suffix T into V divided by 1000. Since the pinion is weaker, so P is equal to Ft1 V1 divided by 1000. We'll call it as equation number 3. Next, pit line velocity V, that is equal to pi D1 N1 divided by 60. We'll substitute the value of N1. N1 value we know, that is 1200 he has given in the problem. So velocity V, we are getting in terms of D1. That is velocity V is equal to 62.831 D1 meters per second. Now, so by substituting these values in equation number 3, we are getting power P is in terms of kilowatts only we need to substitute, because in that equation he has mentioned. So power P is 20 kilowatts, so 20, that is equal to Ft1 into 62.831 D1 divided by 1000. By simplifying that, we are getting the value tangential tooth load by the pinion, that is equal to 318.31 divided by D1 N Newton. We'll call this as equation number 4. Now, by substituting these values in equation 2, we will get F suffix T1, that is equal to 318.31 divided by D1, that is equal to 2MT1 divided by D1. So here the terms, denominator terms, D1, D1 get cancels. We are getting the relation value M suffix T1, that is tangential torque, M suffix T1, that is equal to 159.155 Newton meter. In terms of Newton meters or joules, we are getting now 159.155 into 10 to the 3 Newton millimeters. In this form, we are supposed to get. Now, after obtaining this value, one more unknown is required for the equation number 1, that is K. K is equal to B by M. We'll call that as equation number 5. The face width of gear in terms of module, there will be a relation or a range. What's supposed to be the range of the face width in terms of module? That is from equation number 12.5F, page number 206. The relation is 9.5M to 12.5M. Within this range, face width B has to lie. So, I am assuming face width b is equal to 10m, 10 times the module. Now we'll substitute this in equation number 5. We are getting k is equal to 10m divided by m. m, that is module, will get cancelled. So value of k is equal to 10. After obtaining the ratio k, we'll go to evaluate the form factor. Earlier, what is the value we obtained? That is Lewis form factor, that is denoted by small y. Form factor, that is capital Y. Capital Y is equal to pi into Lewis form factor small y. Or capital Y1, that is equal to pi into Y1. And the value Y1, that is 0.1116. By simplifying that, we are getting form factor Y1, that is equal to 0.3506. Now, we will substitute all the values in equation number 1. That is, equation number 1 is m cube, that is equal to 2mt1 divided by sigma d1 cv ky1 z1. We will substitute all the unknown in this equation. We are getting m cube, that is equal to 2 into 159.155 into 10 to the 3 divided by 193.2 into cv into 10 into 0.3506 into 15. So, we are getting the product m cube into cv, that is equal to 31.32. This is the product. Now, based on this product, we are supposed to do trial and error method. We will call this as equation number 6. Now, by using trial and error method for the obtained value m cube into cv, that is 31.32, we must evaluate the unknown by using trial and error method. So, here I have plotted a table with a last, starting from the last column, the product I need, that is m cube into cv. So, previous to the last column, I considered the term cv. And first column I took it as module m. So m cube into cv, that final product I need. Now to evaluate the cv, we have this set of equations. So, velocity factor cv, we must refer that particular page number for the corresponding value of velocity factor cv. Up to velocity 8 meter per second, we have the relation 3.05 divided by 3.05 plus v. It means we need the value velocity v. Now, previous to this particular column, we must consider the v1. Velocity we need to evaluate. V1 is equal to pi d1 n1 divided by 60 into 1000. So, here the value n1 I know, that is 1200 divided by 60 into 1000. By simplifying that, I am getting v1, velocity v1 in terms of d1, that is 0.0628 d1. So, now to evaluate the value of v1, we must get the value d1 first. So, d1 is equal to m into z1, and here module value we supposed to assume, and z1 value we know, that is 15. So, d1 is equal to 15m. Now, by assuming module m as 1, 3, 5, 4, 4.5, like that, we supposed to refer. Now, for the corresponding module 1mm, d1 is equal to 15 into m, that is 15. By multiplying that 15 with 0.0628, we are getting velocity v1 is equal to 0.942, that is less than 8 meter per second. So, we can go with the equation cv, velocity factor c suffix v is equal to 3.05 divided by 3.05 plus v. So, we are getting the value 0.764. Now, m cube into cv, that is 1 cube into 0.764, we are getting the value 0.764. Now, this value is very much less than the product what we have, that is 31.32. Now, I will go with the one more value, that is module 3. It need not, you have to go to module 3 only. You can go higher value, but finally, we are getting approximation value as same. Now, here I took the value, module M as 3. I got the value D1 by using the same method, what I followed for the first row. So, I am obtaining D1 is 45, V1 is 2.826, CV as 0.519, product m cube cv as 14.013. It is also less value as comparing with the product what we have, that is 31.32. Further, this is the lesser value. So, I supposed to go with the further higher value. So, module m is 5mm. For the corresponding d1 as 75, v1 4.71, cv 0.393, product I am getting as 49.13. So, as comparing with the required product, this will be higher. So, I supposed to reduce the module to 4mm. For the corresponding value 4mm, D1 is 60, V1 is 3.768, C suffix V is 0.447, M cube into CV is 28.608, which is lesser than the required value, that is 31.32. Now, by referring the table 12.2, page number 229, here he has given some of the recommended series of modules. So, in that, preference 1 is module 1, 1.25, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. And in the choice 2, here one more option is there. If value lies in between 4 and 5, option we have 4.5. So now I will consider the value 4.5. So for the corresponding module 4.5, I will get the value D1 is 67.5, V1 is 4.239, CV is 0.4183. So product I am getting, M cube CV, that is 38.117. Now, either I supposed to finalize module 4mm as the final or 4.5. So now I will compare with the required value, that is 31.32. For the same, 28.608 will be the nearest value. So by considering that particular, I will go with the conclusion module as 4mm, and we need to refer the standard recommended series of module from table 12.2, page number 229. So module M is equal to 4mm. So now this is about the first unknown, what he expected in this particular problem, that is module. Module is 4mm. Next, another unknown will be face width. Face width B is equal to, so now by considering the module equation, M cube into something, that particular equation, I will consider a portion. That is here one of the assumption I made for K. So I took value of K as well as M cube into CV. So here actually 1 by M cube into CV is proportional to K, or M cube into CV is inversely proportional to K. That relation I have taken to get the adjusted value of K nu. So by considering the what are the values we have, from the equation number 6, M cube into CV we have 31.32. That is for the corresponding value, that is assumption what we have made, that is face width B is equal to 10 times M, that assumption we made. As per that, 1 divided by 31.32, that is equal to 10. Now, the exact value what we obtained in the table for the corresponding module 4mm is 28.608. So 1 divided by 28.608, that is equal to K nu. Now, by solving equation number 7 and 8, we are getting K nu value as 10.95. By dividing equation 7 and 8, we are getting the value K nu is equal to 10.95. That is approximately equal to 11. So, therefore, the final width, final face width is going to become B is equal to 11m, 11 times the module. So, it is in between the range what he has given, that is 9.5m to 12.5m. So, obviously, this value is in between that. So, this value we can accept. So, that is equal to 11 into module is 4mm. So, finally, the face width B is equal to 44mm. Now, we are able to get both the value. Module M is 4mm and face width B is equal to 44mm. This comes